Good afternoon, guys. It's actually almost 3 o'clock in the afternoon. And I've actually decided I'm going to pull my finger out of my ass and start work on my light that I've been wanting to build. Now that the paint is dry on the plank wood. Now, if you're wondering why I'm dragging out a couple of PC cases, or towers, they're going to be used as a stand, because I'm going to need to drill holes in the plank, and I can't really do that while the plank is flat against the worktop or another surface. So, I'll just get the plank of wood. I'm going to lay it across the towers there, like so, and then I can drill the holes and move the plank left to right, which, you know, to accommodate wherever I need to drill the hole, and hey presto. I was going to put spotlights on this, but not sure that I will now. At least not the ones I've got, because they're a bit large. They take the really large bulbs, and I want one. Well, actually, I could do two. Something this sort of size. I'd take the smaller bulbs. But I've only got that one, so that's not a lot of good. So, I'm going to have to use one of these, and I'm going to place them all on. And pencil out the marks so I know where they've got to go, so I can screw them down and drill the hole. And I've got a drill bit. Where the heck did I just put that drill bit? And, oh, there it is. Wood bit. I didn't want to use a spade bit because I thought the hole would be made far too large. I think this one might make it just about big enough. I've only got a couple of small bits of flat flex to get through the hole. Ooh, pardon me. But if this doesn't do it any bigger, make a big enough hole, I should say. The only bigger bits I've got are metal bits. So I'll just use one of those just to skim the hole a bit bigger, if I have to. So, need that. I might actually have to go answer call of nature before I continue. I'm going to need my Clark. Good old Clark drill. What's that one? That's a 24 volt, and I think the yellow ones are 18 volt. Now that one doesn't have hammer action on it. I better switch that into drill mode, actually. There's got all your torque settings and then drill. Drill. Right. Yeah. Oh, I've got a pencil if I need it. My stationery box up here. Let's step over there and grab the box of screws, because I'm going to need some fairly short ones for these. I don't want bloody great long ones, do I? Right. I know they're not evenly spaced, but I'll space them out in a bit. I'll just get these out. I don't know what it is. But every time I turn the camera on, almost, I need to go drop one in the toilet. It's a psychological thing, isn't it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, so I need one more. So I was going to put 8 on there, weren't I? Nope. Yeah, I'll sort all that out in a minute. Right, so I shall be back. Okay, I'm back. And I don't need those connector blocks, because I can terminate straight into the lamp holder. So I've already got the hole drilled for that, and the power cable, and the first piece of wire to loop to the next one. So all I've got to do for the first lamp is just to strip some wire back, terminate it, and put it all together. I'm not going to need a great deal. I'm trying to figure out what's going to be the most comfortable way to do this. Probably sat down as I am. And I did need two drill bits because that one wasn't quite long enough. So, I think the easiest way for me to do this is to cut the ends back on both wires. Give myself plenty to play with. Live, one neutral, one blue, one brown. I'm going to do the same with this one. So, we end up with two bare wires. Whoopsie! I didn't want to do that. Severed the neutral wire, which means I've got to pull a bit further, put more cable out. That's all. So, trim that off. Trim that off. Now. I'm trying to think of the easiest way to do this. Good, I brought the screwdriver over with me. Hopefully, I can get two wires into the terminals on the lamp holder. I'm hoping. Twist these up. Do the same in these two. And then it's just a case of twisting the two blues together like so, and two browns. And of course I've just got to repeat this all the way along. It doesn't matter which terminal you put them in on the lamp holder. It'll work either way. There's no right and the wrong way with these. So long as you put all your blues together and all your browns together. Two brown, two blue, that's all you got to remember. It doesn't matter what terminals you put them on these lamp holders. Right. I think we are almost there with the first one. put the lamp holder back in the casing. And there is a couple of little cutouts for it to lock into. You just screw the little collar on. I don't know why I didn't check to see if I could terminate straight into the lamp holders. But that's not a bad thing, because I can still, come on, I'll just get through there. I can still, use those connector blocks for other projects. So now, in theory, that should screw on like that. We've got our first one done. Just like that. To make sure that goes nice and secure into there. I have got some sticky back clips I can use. Swap for the wood bit. Marks so I know where the lamp has got to go. Let's see if I can unscrew this again. Yep. The other one didn't want to unscrew. So, gotta get up for this bit. Just got to go on like that. I'm just going to draw a little mark on the board, like that. Grab a drill. I'm also putting these bases not on tight enough, aren't they? I'm also putting these bases up the same way, so the holes for the cable are all going to be along the top as we look at it. That way, I'll know it'll the cable will run in a straight line. Anyway, my batteries are about to die on this, so I'm going to change those. And I'll get a bit more done and I'll come back. that is the general process of what I've got to do. I've just got to feed this cable up through the hole, and I'm going to have to feed another one in. Hold on a minute. And I will trim it down, and I think I could probably get another loop out of this. It does mean the wiring is going to be pretty close to the base and a bit fiddly, but it doesn't matter. Right. So, I'll turn off, change the batteries, get another few done, I suppose. Just got to change the spacing of a couple of these. Yeah, that's roughly the spacing I want. So I'll get that next one done, and I'll find some more cable. When I say find some more cable, I've got plenty of power cables like that I can cut up. So, I don't mind cutting a few up. So, I shall return. Okay, we have a progress update. First four are on. I've just got these four to finish. I've got the wires in place. I was going along doing one by one, drilling the holes when I'd come to the next one, then wiring up, then mark out the hole for the next one, drill it, screw it down, and so on. But I decided, as I had these four left, I'll just do it this way. So I went along and drilled all the holes, screwed all the bases down, hopefully up the right way. Yep, they are all up the right way. Thankfully I have not made that boo-boo yet. Right. I'll put the camera on for a little while. What's in the view? Is that in the view? Oh, that's enough in the view. Right. Just seen a post on Facebook which is talking about a dog that's being left in a garage all day alone and then put outside at night, all night in all weathers. And I did ask if that was the one I can hear at night when I'm outside. I can only hear it when I'm outside. Just, well, it sounds like it's up the road somewhere from here. I can hear a dog barking, and it's been doing that several nights in a row. I don't know if it's been doing it all night, because, like I said, I can only hear it if I go outside. Because up here, with these double-glazed windows and other noises and whatnot, I just don't hear a lot of what goes on outside. Sometimes this insulation can be pretty tough. That's the way to do it. Loop. I'm not sure which job on this is actually the most time consuming, stripping the wires back, drilling the holes and fitting the bases, or fitting the friggin' lamps. It's good job I've got a box of rubbish beside me as well, isn't it? So I'm just going. Even though I still chuck bits on the floor, so. Right. You know, ever since I was an electrician's mate in my last high school year, I've always stripped wires with side cuts. Always. That's how the other Sparkies used to do it that I worked with, so it's just, I suppose it's a habit I picked up from them. I don't know. bloody hell, and I clicked that bit of insulation, it went straight in the box. It would probably be a lot easier with wire strippers, and I have got two pairs somewhere. But like I said, it's more of a habit, it's something I've always done. I wouldn't recommend doing this on really thin wires though, because with a pair of good wire cutters like these, you'll go straight through them. But all I do is just run it round, score the insulation, and then pull. I thought that landed in there somewhere. Right, so now I've got my four wires stripped back. Some longer than the others, but never mind. I'm going to twist two blues together, my two neutrals. I've made that a bit long, so I'm just going to trim the end off. And we do the same with our browns. Yeah, cables aren't going to be flat against the back of this board, but I do have some of them clips left, so I'm going to use those. And it's a little bit long, so I'm just going to snip the end. And we grab our lamp holder, and thankfully the contacts, I don't know if you can see it, but they're quite deep, see? So you can use quite long wire, which is actually good if you've got to twist wires together like this. Just do the screw up, nice and tight. Live. This is where you could do like three hands. One to hold the lamp holder, one to hold the screwdriver, and one to hold the epoxy wire in place. That. Pick this up, and there is two tabs to lock the lamp holder in place like that. Stop the lamp holder actually turning when you put the lamp, light bulb in. I seem to have misplaced the collar. Oh, no, I think that might be a... Is that the one that broke on this one? Yeah. That's alright, I didn't misplace it, it broke on this one. But that doesn't matter, because I've got a couple of spare lamp holders kicking about. There we go. Down. You could put, if you're putting these lights on the ceiling, which is what they're meant to be for, you could put like a skirt on there and screw it to the light, screw a lampshade to it. And I've also noticed that here is a little notch growing up as well, and there's a notch cut out in there, so they line up again just to stop the whole fitting from rotating when you put a light bulb in the fin, screw that down, and there we go, it's another one done. Three more to go. And another one's done, and another one's done, and another one bites the dust. Well, it hasn't really bit the dust in this case, has it? Oh, I got bored earlier, so I went downstairs, and where Victory Housing is finished. Benched. That's why Sean Connery coming out in me again, look. I wonder if he was my dad in a past life. Anyway. Where Victory had fenced that tree off, they're going to take down at some point, I presume. I don't know when. Whenever they can get their contractors out to do it, I suppose. I'd left a gap there with one of the big fence panels out, metal fence panels out, because there was a car park there and I had to put the fence around the car, so I left a gap for that to get out. But I never came back to put the other panel in, so as I've noticed, people have been piss-arsing around in there. I've taken the liberty to do it for them. Because them panels aren't heavy to lift on your own. Not by a long shot. done that and bolted that in place and shifted a few cones around, and I even had a sweep up of sticks out there. Because I know there's two people in this block that own motorbikes. I'm pretty certain they wouldn't want punctures. And I know I don't particularly want punctures in any of my bikes, and so I decided as I was out there, I'll just grab my broom and have a quick sweep up. That does hurt your fingers. It really does. I'm going to shunt across to my left in a bit. Right, what I'm going to do, I want these all the same height if I can, so I'm just going to trim them and shoot bits of wire here, there, and everywhere while I'm at it. Right, now strip all four wires back. I've been watching a new YouTuber. Well, I say a new YouTuber, I've been subscribed. I don't know how long I've been subscribed to him now. I can't actually remember. I know it's not that long, but he's called him, I think I've already mentioned him, BigClive.com. He does some pretty interesting electrical videos. For anyone watching my channel, who's interested in electrical bits, or electrical stuff, and not so much electronics, I don't think. Well, yeah, it does do electronics. Hi, Nemo. But yeah, I do find his videos quite interesting to watch. So, if you want to, you can go and check him out. I'm not getting paid to mention any of these channels, you know. I just mention the channels I like to watch. If I like to watch them, I'll mention them. And I do like to watch them. I watch a bit of everything. Yeah. I'll turn that camera a bit. That one's a bit long, so I'll trim that back in a minute. It's not going to take me long, is it, to do all these lights? After I've done this one on the the second one from the end, I'm going to have to go on a collar hunt. But like I said, with these, it doesn't matter what terminals you put the live or the neutral on, as long as you keep the colours matched. So in this case, two blue, two brown together. So long as you do that, it's fine. Don't cross them, because then you will go bang. And you don't want to do that. Got the notches lined up for the lamp holder. Screw the collar on. Like so. Push the lamp holder down. This and spread that, and there's another one. That's six done. I don't think these are evenly spaced. I've just dyed them up. I'll do. I don't think anyone's going to study it enough to pay that much attention. So right, so I've got enough lamp holders left, but I've only got one of them. Just got to find where the hell I put my I should have two spare lamp holders somewhere. Well, now I've got one, it's full of dirt, which is why I'm not using it. So I can nick a collar off of that one. A collar off of any one of any sort of lamp holder that's got a collar like this on it, even if it's a pendant, it'll fit. Because they're all the same in size thread. It's about one of the few things that does come in a single standard size. Now take bikes for instance, you can get different widths of bottom brackets, different sized bottom bracket bearings, different sized seat stems, different sized handlebar stems, different sized steerer tubes on forks. No standard size throughout, like with these lamp holders, they're all a standard size. No! Other companies have to be a pain in the ass and have lots of different sizes. Right. I'll get off my fat ass in a minute and I'll go find the other collar when I get to it. I didn't do it yet because I'm not there. Right. At least the last one's easy. It's only got the one thing on. Cable, I should say. So I've only got the one to cut back. Right. Had one heck of a boring day. So I did go away and do a few other things when I turned the camera off. From the, when I finished the last segment on this. I haven't seen anyone, no one's visited, no one ever visited me anyway. Not unless they want something. It's the only time I ever see anyone. They love me when they want something. Nah, I'm only kidding. Only joking. Ah, you son of a... Oh, I've took the scab off my burn again. It's got to be the fourth time now. It's healing up nicely now, that scab anyway, so it don't matter. If I weren't being a pillock, I wouldn't have burnt myself in the first place. Now, tell that those four wires are too long, so... Whee! Most of those went in the bin. I have to get the vac out in a bit when I'm done because there's loads of sawdust everywhere and just chuck it all in there. Well, I managed to get most of this wired up with just the one power cable cut up because I found out I had six power cables. I'll show you that. And use these connectors, so I just took a couple. I didn't really need six. Just collie walked a couple out of the pile, and I've literally done this with one whole cable and just a bit to do this from here to there. Literally, just that one last little bit. One. Like working in a factory, it's just a repetitive process. But it does depend on how much willpower you've got to be this repetitive. So I know some people wouldn't be, and they'd get bored after the first few and then give up. Which is why I actually went away and took a break for an hour or so and then came back. I actually think that hour or so break turned into a couple of hours. I'm not going to pin. I started to clip the cable down up that end just to see how well it clipped into place. And it did work. But I'm going to put bulbs in and check this work. I've actually been debating whether to upgrade the fuse and the plug. Because it's only got a 3 amp fuse in it. And I've got a feeling something like this is going to pull possibly pull a bit more than 3 amps. I was going to upgrade it to a 5 or something. I'll plug it in and see what happens, because the worst it's going to do is pop the fuse anyway. That's all it'll do. And it's easy enough to change the bleeding fuse. I don't like how those are twisted together, you've got to redo those ones. Always taught in college that when you terminate wires, you should always leave a teeny little bit showing. A teeny bit of copper wire showing, but I've never figured out why. I don't like to do that, I like to get as much covered as possible. If I can, I'll cover the whole lot, but these is always, each one of these have got a little dinky bit showing. I don't know why. This is just to ensure that you've got just the metal making contact. I keep looking around the room to see if I can see another 2 lamp holders. I can't find them. I'll get a box of gloves out of the cupboard in a minute. Right. Last one. Which is there. Somewhere. Well, let's get this script back and the lamp holder connected at least. I wonder if I've put it over back by the computer desk somewhere. Might be what I did with it. Yep, this one stripped back quite easily. I was just checking that the memory card hadn't filled up on me, because I've still got the other 2 segments to this video on there. Shouldn't have done, to be honest. Should now have done. Right. One. Should be seeing Mum tomorrow, but I don't know if I'm actually going to go over. I hope so, because I'd like to take my wood over and get that all trimmed up and the top ready so I can bring it back and stick it up on the wall. I would like to get my Lego desk sorted out. Fed up of having half-finished projects dotted about. So I'd like to actually finish something once in a while. I have a habit of doing that, and I don't know why. But not finishing things. The same with courses. Very few courses have I actually ended up completing in my life. But I don't know if that's just Asperger's related, I don't know. Here, lampy holder. Ah, found it. We threw it back in the box, I guess. Probably got a lamp holder with one of these collars on in the box of electrical bits under the bed. Anyway, you know what? Almost ready to turn it on and test. There's some green shit on the contacts of some of these, but that should work. I'll clean that off later. Right. Get that down there. Get that on there. Screw that on. There we go. Okay. Well, obviously, for my own safety, I'm looking at this clock, I've got about 15 minutes of recording left before the card's full, so I'm going to go and find a box. Well, I say find a box. I know where the box of bulbs is. It's behind this clump of wood. You can't see because it's too dark. There we go. In there. I'm trying to set the camera there so you can go for a ride on the box. All these bulbs. Okay, so what should we start with? Let's start with one yellow one, or orange one, or whatever colour you want to call it. Green. Blue, and if I can, I'm going to repeat the process. So I'm going to do it that way as well. Green, red, yellow, green, blue. Yeah. Right, I'll set you there for the moment. Didn't blow the 3-amp fuse either. Here we go. All fine. I've just got to sort the cable out on the underside, just tidy that up a bit. You can see it's hanging in places. Which is all I'm going to use them sticky back clips for, just to tidy it up. I've got enough in here, I think. Yeah, and what cut all between each section. I like that. I just think you could put LED bulbs in that, or whatever bulbs you wanted. White bulbs, I've got lots of white ones in there. I could do all green, all yellow, all red. Actually, I don't think I could do all red. I don't think I've got enough bulbs. But you catch my drift anyway. Let's just turn it off, shall we? It is alive! There we go. So, I suppose the same principle would apply if you're in America. You just need to know. I can hear a loud buzz from somewhere. I think it's coming from that computer area. My main computer area. Anyway, as I was saying, I suppose if you're in America or any country, the same principle would apply, but you'd have to make sure you know which is the live wire and which is your neutral wire in your country. And I think in America it's white is the live. If I remember correctly, so you'd put all your whites together and all your blacks together. I think that's how they do it. I'm sure someone from America will correct me on that one if I've got it wrong. But yeah, you just got to make sure you basically just match up your colours, because these are light bulbs. There isn't a right or a wrong way, unless it's a screw-in light bulb. There is a right way to do that, and there is a reason for it. I haven't got a screw-in bulb at hand, I don't think. No. But as you know, with a screw-in bulb, what I can do, I can show you up here. I'm going to get this bulb out one-handed. I may put some lower wattage bulbs in here, because they're both 100 watts. But what I normally do, if I don't need to use both spots, like I only needed that one earlier, I'll just loosen the bulb in this one so it don't work. I'm going to put the light back on, I think. Right, so with a screw-in bulb, or a screw-in lamp holder, you have a contact at the bottom that contacts that, and the side of the lamp holder is the other contact. The right way to wire up a screw-in light bulb is to make sure you put the live wire to the bottom pin, not the side screw thread, the bottom pin. The reason for that is, if you're unscrewing the light bulb, not so much with this spotlight, but if a standard fitting like that, for example, or a table lamp, there's always a risk that someone might accidentally touch this part while it's still making contact with the metal screw thread in the lamp holder. So you do have to make sure you put neutral to the metal threads and live to the bottom contact. Yeah, I think that's easy enough to remember. Why am I going over there? I don't know why I'm going over there. But yeah, if I don't want to use two spotlights, I'll just loosen that one up. And if I want to use it, whee. That one's a bright one. That one's really bright. Yeah, I might actually put them out. Take these R80 100 watts out and put some R60 60 watts in. Just to dim it down. But I won't know if I'll need these 100 watts in until I've got the table itself sorted. Oh, I've got one more job to do with these, and that's to fit the couple of eyelets or something so I can hang it up. Yeah, I found my lead. I took this lead off an old lamp. It's got a switch in line, a sealed switch. So I can just switch on and off. And that can be used for a multitude of things. You can have different style of lights in there. I've got loads of different styles, so I might have a play later. Because I've got a box full of different bulbs under the bed. I haven't tested those strings yet.
No strings attached.
Oh, my sticky tape just fell off the cabinet. Oh well. I could make something similar up using those in that box, or this string. I could do it with that little string in there. So I've got another length of this in the shed. So I could make something a bit different up and have a couple of them. I think something like this might look better with a single colour in it. Yeah. Anyway, that's it for this video. Hope you enjoyed my simple build. I've also got to do one more thing, but I don't think I've got enough time. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this build. Simple little project. Probably more time consuming than anything. But that's something you can try at home if you want to make your own decorative light for parties. You don't even have to hang it. You know, you could just you could mount it on the wall that way up. Because you could actually mount that to a wall if you wanted to.